substances to be eliminated. There are a number of chemical substances which are regularly formed in our body or which absorbed through the food. So there are a number of chemical substances as we discussed. Otherwise, so if it remains through the food, that must be eliminated. Whatever we are taking the food, that must be eliminated. Otherwise, they become harmful. Some of such substances are carbon dioxide and water. And second one is nitrogenous metabolic waste, salts and vitamins, and then water, bile pigments. So these are to be eliminated. The primary function of respiratory system is to take oxygen and eliminate carbon dioxide, that is elimination of carbon dioxide. Oxygen passes quickly through this air-blood barrier into the blood in the capillary. Similarly, carbon dioxide passes from the blood into alveoli and then it is exhaled out. Excess nitrogenous waste is excreted from the body. The nitrogenous waste tend to form toxic ammonia. This raises the pH of body fluids. While aquatic animals can easily excrete ammonia into their watery surroundings, terrestrial animals have evolved special mechanisms. They have a special terrestrial animal means land animals which live on land are terrestrial animals have evolved special mechanisms to eliminate the toxic ammonia from their systems. And aquatic animals which live in water are aquatic animals. Terrestrial animals which live on land are terrestrial animals. You know the difference, right? So next, what is the elimination of other substances? Bilirubin is a yellow substance that made when the body breaks down old red blood cells. It leaves the body through the urine and stool. So in a pregnant woman, so the body removes bilirubin from the baby through the placenta. So after the birth, the baby body must get rid of the bilirubin on its own. The liver is well known to metabolize and excrete into bile many compounds and toxins, thus eliminating them from the body. So this bilirubin pigments, the liver cells extract it from the circulation and secrete it into the bile juice poured into duodenum through the common bile duct. So where it is sent into duodenum through the common bile duct. The pigments are modified in the intestine to the pigments and give in the fecus their yellowish brown color. Some of these pigments are excreted in the urine. So excretion is the removal of harmful and unwanted nitrogenous waste products from the body. See, this is the structure of the excretory organs. So, excretion in humans is brought about by the following organs, that is skin, lungs, liver and kidneys also. Kidneys, these are primary excretory organs eliminating nitrogenous waste, chiefly urea from the blood and throwing it out in the form of urine. And skin, it excretes water and salts. And lungs, excretion by the lungs in the form of carbon dioxide and released in expired air. And then sweat glands, that is through the skin. Sweat glands is incidental. These glands are primarily concerned with cooling. The sweat secreted also carries with a small amount of nitrogenous waste. And sweat glands pass out sweat only when required for cooling. So truly they are not excretory. Next, liver converts nitrogenous waste into urea. So these are about the structures of excretory systems. Next, kidneys. They are the primary excretory organs eliminating nitrogenous waste, the blood throwing into out in the form of urine. So excretion is eliminating substance bilirubin. So this is about the structure of kidneys, the human urinary system. So renal, so when you see the two bean shaped structures, so on the top it is having adrenal gland, it is associated with the renal artery and vein, and kidneys two bean shaped, one is situated, two bean shaped organs about 10 centimeters long and 6 centimeters wide, located on either side of the backbone and protected by the two last ribs. The right side of kidney is slightly lower than the left one. See, the right one is slightly lower than the left one. A tube, the ureter, rises from the notch ileum in the median surface of each kidney and connects behind with urinary bladder. In the lower part of the abdomen, the front of the ureter is somewhat expanded into the kidney and is called pelvis, that is a basin cup. The urine produced in the kidney consistently flow through the ureters and from ureters and collects in the urinary bladder. The urine is intermediately emptied from the urinary bladder to the outside of the body through the urethra. The opening of ureters into the bladder are somewhat projecting and act like walls to prevent the back flow of urine when bladder contracts to pass out the urine. A sphincter muscle, it is also called a circular muscle, guards the opening of the bladder into urethra and relaxes only when at the time of urination. Urination is also called micturition, under an impulse from the brain. So renal artery, veins, adrenal gland. So this is about the kidney structure. So regarding the structure of kidney tubules, we'll discuss it next class.